Hello, world travelers, and welcome to GeoQ, an app like no other. I'm one of your hosts, Chase.
And my name is Sunny. We've been trotting the globe together for some time now. That's what led us to develop GeoQ.
Yep, since we launched the GeoQ app, our global quest has gone to a whole new level.
It's so cool. GeoQ gives us the green light to travel, and it drops us in a completely new and exciting location. Then you get to help us figure out where we are.
Because we never know where we're going until we get there. Once we land, you'll play a game to figure out our location and then hunt for a souvenir. And I love souvenirs because it's like you get to take a little piece of somewhere with you.
That's right, and each time you help us find a souvenir, it unlocks a clue about our next quest. Now, before we jump right into all that our GeoQ app has to offer, we need to fill you in on some of our greatest travel hacks.
And in case you don't know what a travel hack is, it's a helpful tip or trick that can help you when you're on the go.
All right, to find out today's travel hack, it's time to play a game, and this one is called What's Missing?
You'll see a picture with a bunch of travel essentials. You'll get a few seconds to look at them before one disappears, then you'll guess which one you think is missing.
Let's test your memory.
What's missing?
You guys were awesome. Today's travel hack is to make sure that you don't forget your wallet when it's time for takeoff.
Yeah, because if you forget your wallet, the only souvenirs you're gonna be able to take home with you are the free maps from the visitor center.
It's unfortunate, but true.
Well, here is one travel hack that will never let you down. You've gotta make sure you have some tunes queued up to help the time go by.
And I've got one fired up and ready to kick us off. Everyone stand up and let's sing this together. Now I'm ready to wander.
Me too. Let's see where GeoQ takes us today.
Grab your suitcase, my friend. It's time to go. Good This is really awesome. It doesn't look like anywhere we've landed before.
You're right about that. It's beautiful though.
Seriously, let's play a game and see if our travel buddies can figure out where we are today.
Let's play sheep, panda, dog. You'll have 5 seconds to choose which animal you want to be. You can either be a sheep like they have in New Zealand, a panda from China, or a dog like you'd find in Mexico. If your animal disappears from the screen, that means we're not traveling to that country today, and you'll sit down. If you're ready to play, stand up and get ready, because here we go. Sit down if you chose sheep. Sit down if you chose panda. Dog wins. Today, you've landed in Mexico. Location confirmed.
Yes, we're in Mexico. Good job, GeoQuesters.
With all the cacti, chocolate, and people speaking Spanish, I think I've found my new favorite place to travel.
Hola, mis amigos. Yo soy Juan Durán, your highest quester investor for all your global adventures. And today, you've arrived in Mexico. This place is beautiful, as you can already see. But wait, do you feel that? That slight sinking feeling? You're not just imagining things. Nope. Mexico is actually sinking at the rate of 6 to 8 inches every single year. That means Mexico will be completely underwater one day. Never fear while you're here, though, because scientists predict that it'll be a couple hundred years before that happens. So you've got plenty of time to build your submarine. Until then, why don't you enjoy some chocolate? Mexican chocolate has quite the spice. Not your thing? No worries. There's plenty of popcorn to go around. Before it was your favorite movie theater snack, the corn kernels got popping here first. Still not your deal? Maybe a 150-pound tamale would hit the spot. Mexico is not just known for their love of food, but also dogs. This country loved a certain tiny dog so much that they named it after the great state of Chihuahua. Now that's a cute little guy. They should have named the whole country after him. Well, let's not forget Mexico's amazing pottery. If someone says they're continuing the family business, they're probably talking about the art of making clay pots. Those pots are used for everything, from cooking to even decorating churches. But that's not all you'll find while you're here. There are many sports you can play during your visit. Among the most popular are soccer, baseball, and even, are you ready for this? Are you ready for this? Bullfighting, ole! To make your time in Mexico even more special, of course we have a souvenir for you. You can find them at coordinates. Wait, I've been brushing up on my Spanish. Let's give this a try. The coordinates are 23 Norte y la de la noche es bueno barito. Maybe I should keep practicing. Either way, we've loaded them into GeoQ just to be on the safe side. Here are some clues of what you're questing after today. They're not hard to come by. They're everywhere to be found. Each one is uniquely crafted and made by hand. And the final clue, it's nice to have on hand because it has many uses. Make sure you log it when you find it.
I love souvenirs, but I've started to really love our souvenir badges even more.
Me too. We always have something to remember the awesome places we've been. You can't lose them, they're always just the right size, and we never have issues fitting them on the plane.
And when you find them, they unlock our next quest. Keep your eyes on the screen and listen out for us to give you the clues to find this week's souvenir. First up, clue number one. You can find them anywhere.
Food is everywhere. I hope it's something I can snack on.
Well, our second clue says that each one is uniquely crafted by hand.
Tamales are crafted by hand.
Oh boy. Well, I think our third clue will rule out tamales because it says that it's nice to have on hand because of its many uses. Any guesses from our fellow questers? You have just a few more seconds.
It was a clay jar.
Great work, GeoQuest users. Now that you found today's souvenir, let's see what Juan's got to say.
Ah, perfect. For real though, so many uses. Before my bebida was in there, which is Spanish for drink, this was just a pencil holder, and now, refreshing. You know, I'm so glad you found the jar because it has a very special story that goes along with it. I mean, what would a souvenir be without a great story? This one is from the Bible and is about a prophet named Elijah who God would drop special messages on for the people to hear. One day, God told Elijah to go to the valley near the Jordan River. Elijah didn't mind, but he wondered, what's there to eat? Did he need to bring a lunch or what? God let Elijah know that he didn't need to worry about his next meal because he could drink from the brook and get this, ravens, those, they would be delivering his food. Elijah took off towards the Jordan River, and sure enough, the ravens brought him an awesome meal every morning and night. Too bad they couldn't bring him a pepperoni pizza.
Hi. Yeah, ravens? I'd like to order a large pizza with extra cheese and pepperoni. Yeah, and a side of breadsticks. Okay, thanks, bye.
Things were great, but there was just one problem. It hadn't rained for a long time, and eventually, the brook was bone dry. What was Elijah gonna do? This could have been a big problem for him, but he knew that God always provided for what he needed. And without fail, God told Elijah to leave the valley and go to another town where he would meet a widow. She would take care of him from there. Elijah obeyed, and just like God said, there she was, gathering sticks. So Elijah walked up to her and asked her if she could bring him a jar of water. As she walked away to get his drink, Elijah then asked her for a piece of bread too. Ya boy needed to grub. The widow told Elijah that she didn't have any bread and only a small bit of flour and a drop or two of oil. In fact, that's why she was gathering sticks, to go home and cook one last meal for herself and her son. After that, she was sure this would be the end of the road. They would starve and die. Elijah told her not to worry, you know, about the whole dying thing, but to go home and make some food. He told her to bring him a loaf for one. After that, she could make some bread for her and her son. Elijah let her know that God had said she wouldn't run out of flour or oil. So the widow went back home and did what Elijah told her to do. And sure enough, it worked. Elijah had food every single day. And there was even enough food for the widow and her son. It was like an all-you-can-eat bread buffet. Bread for days, y'all. The jar of flour wasn't used up, and the jug always had oil in it. God provided what they needed and more. So, Questers, when you look at that jar, remember that one of the names of God is Provider. That's because God loves us and knows exactly what we need. He promises to provide for us, and he does. Well, until we meet again, keep on questing like the bestin'. Adios, mis amigos.
That's really cool. When we're looking back on our time in Mexico, we'll always have this clay jar badge to remind us that God is our provider.
He knows everything we'll ever need, and he provides it for us. Seeing that this jar pours out water when we need it will remind me that God pours out great blessings on us all the time.
Come on, fellow questers, say this after me. God is my provider.
My provider.
Want to sing another one of our travel songs?
Yeah, stand up and let's sing together.
You call.
I hope you've had as much fun in our app as we have.
That's all the time we have to play today, so let's all bow our heads, close our eyes, and pray together.
Father God, thank you for showing us more about who you are. We are so thankful that you are our provider. Thank you for knowing what we need even before we know to ask for it. Because you are so good, we don't have to worry about anything. We love you. Amen.
See you all next week.